Dear CG Thinker, welcome. How did I do this? After the release of the last version of Materializer, I was asked several times, how did I do the engraving on the lock? I give you in this video my technique. You will see how to make the image that we will use as decal and how to use it in Blender. We start by creating the decal. You will need a drawing program. You can use anything from Photoshop, GIMP, Krita, Inkscape, etc. I will use Affinity Designer. If you don't have it, it doesn't matter at all. It's extremely easy to do, so it doesn't matter what software you use. What is important is to understand and remember the principle. We start with the drawing software, with the creation of an empty document of 2048 pixels of size. The basic design is very simple. The background should be black and your design should be white. I start by editing my text. If you want to put more than text, you will need a silhouette style image. To make the thumbnail of the YouTube video, I want to Google icons. There are plenty of icons in SVG format. Once again, the format of your sources and the software used do not matter. The main thing is to write in white on a black background and do imperatively what I'm going to say now. Once your design is done, the last step is to blur your image. For my part, I will apply a blur of 3 pixels. Save and you're done. So, I summarize what you have to do on your favorite software. Write in white on a black background and blur it. Now, let's go to Blender. Here is the demo scene in which I made the thumbnail of the video. We are going to texture the button that is waiting for us. I start by creating a material and add a new layer that I set for a metallic look. I add a decal by pressing the F key and clicking on the Add button in the decal section. The selection window opens and of course I choose the image I just created. For those of you who did not follow the tutorial on decals, after choosing your image, Materializer adds an empty to your scene and automatically selects it for positioning. Press the G key and hold down Ctrl key to move the empty and make it follow the surface of the object. I reduce the size of the empty, reduce the size of the decal. By selecting the button again, we can see that the decal node have been added to the material. We can also see in the output that our image is there. I don't know if you realized it, but the black and white image you created is an height map. And like any height map, you can use it with a bump nodes to make a normal map. Then select the color output to the height input of bump node and connect it to the normal input of the layer. As you can see, the relief is not in the expected direction. By checking the invert box, I get a good engraving. I also advise you to decrease the distance parameter to get more details to have smoother curves. All you have to do is adjust the straight, like you want. a good engraving does not stop there. I give you one last tip to make the result more realistic. In reality, for reason of ambient occlusion or even burns due to the engraving, the inside of the letters are darker. That's why I advise you to use the color output to make the inside of the engraving darker. As a bonus, I would like to show you something pretty fun that allows you to play with the slopes of your engraving. Add a float curve node just before the bump node. By playing with the curve, you can change the appearance of the slope of your engraving. Add a few points and for once do whatever you want, and you will see that there are some nice effects. Before leaving you to give you all information concerning the realization of the miniature or the video, I added a node radial brushed after the node bump to give this brushed steel effect. Well, you know how I did it in my demo image. You can now engrave any text or symbol on any surface. You are now a little more independent and you don't need someone to get a word decal library to make your creations. If you like 3D, not just to watch others, but to do it yourself, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next videos. See you soon, because we get tired of everything except learning. Bye bye.